In this demo, we will show four steps in a rapid SCA prototyping process. First, we'll use the SystemVue product to design and test a radio system. With a working design, the next step is to export the functional design from SystemVue into the Spectra CX product, where we will assemble the components into an SCA-compliant radio application. The third step will be to deploy and run the waveform. In today's demo, we will use Spectra OE running in a virtual machine environment as our SCA-compliant radio operating environment. Finally, and you probably haven't seen anything like this before, we're going to link the simulation to the running SCA application. This innovative capability provides us with many new options in terms of how we prototype and verify the application. Let's go back to step one, the design. In this design, there are two major components, the QPSK transmitter and the QPSK receiver. We also have a channel model that we've implemented just to give us an interesting way to connect the transmitter to the receiver. The remaining components are there to support the simulation, including a bit generator to drive the transmitter and a bit array tester looking at both the bits we're putting in and the bits at the output of the receiver. We also have a vector signal analyzer to analyze the analog signals. Now, the major components in this subcircuit are actually a hierarchical design. So let's open one up and take a look inside. Inside the QPSK transmitter, we see multiple components which are connected together to provide the required functionality. In this case, we have a modulator which converts the bits into baseband IQ signals and a Nyquist filter to shape the pulses and limit the signal bandwidth. Let's go back to the main schematic, run the simulation, and verify that everything is working. Okay. We have a reasonable looking constellation, so we're happy with the design. Let's move on to the next step of creating SCA compliant components from the subcircuits developed here. To do this, we will use SystemVue's C++ code generation functionality to create three files. The CPP file, which implements the functionality of our subcircuit, an include file, and an XML file, which describes a component. Once exported, we'll then move over into Spectra CX, where we will use the import wizard to create SCA components with all of the proper interfaces. There, we will also add implementation-specific dependencies, such as the Linux OS and x86 processor dependencies shown here. First, we'll generate the C++.h and XML files using SystemVue's code generator. Here we have the three components, our baseband channel, QPSK receiver, and transmitter. Let's create the functional files by pressing the Generate Now button. Okay, we're all done. Now we'll switch to Spectra CX, where I'll use the newly created files to create SCA components. Let's start with the QPSK receiver. I'll just select that within Spectra CX. And we'll place to put it. And let's go ahead and import using the import wizard. Okay, we're all done. Let's take a look at what the import wizard has done for us. I'm going to open SCA demo. And we'll look at the QPSK receiver that we just imported. And while you weren't looking, I created a component diagram that allows us to see all of the elements that were created for us. So we have the functionality, the implementation, and we have the interfaces, the I and Q and output and a resource interface, so forth and so on. Now, the design isn't quite finished, and what we would do within Spectra CX is to finish off this SCA component. For example, we might come in and add a Linux OS dependency. Let me just do that real quickly here so you get the idea. So we'll link this particular Linux dependency to this specific implementation, and we could have multiple implementations. Now, we would finish off the design, and once we had all of our components done, then we can start building our waveform or radio applications. And here we have three components, our transmitter, baseband channel, and QPSK receiver connected just pretty much the way they were in SystemVue. But we've also added a controller to start, stop the application, so forth and so on. Now, when we ran the wizard, it also created an application for us. These are little test applications that simply have the component. Let's go ahead and run this QPSK receiver test application. To do that, I'll switch over here to our monitor. And what we'll see is we have a platform that has three GPPs in it. This is our virtual platform, Spectra E. And we have our application factories over here. So let's go to the receiver test app, create an application. I'm going to call it QPSK RX. Okay. And should just take a second. All done. And we'll go ahead and start that running. So, at this point, we've gone all the way from creating and simulating a design to an SCA application running on an SCA OE. Now, while the application is running, there's not much to see, so let's come full circle and use SystemVue to give this running application something useful to do. This is what we're going to do. We have the test app running on the OE. We're going to use the SystemVue simulation to drive the inputs of the real application and to analyze the output. This allows us to verify that the SCA component behaves in the radio the same way it did in the simulation. This capability has other uses too. We could just as easily look at this diagram and observe that the simulation is actually implementing the QPSK TX component, which isn't installed and running on the platform. To tie SystemVue to the running application, we're first going to have to modify the QPSK receiver component. In SystemVue, a component can support multiple models. For example, a component could have both an HDL model and a subcircuit model. We're going to use this polymorphic modeling capability to switch the receiver from a subcircuit mode we used earlier to one that can communicate with the running application. Let me just open up the properties. And the mode that we're going to select now is the OE model. And when I do that, you can observe the parameters used to establish communications. You may recall that when we created and started the receiver application, we called it QPSKRX, and you'll see that name here. We have also observed the parameters specific to the operating environment's domain name manager and naming service. Okay, now when we start the simulation, it will look pretty much the same as before. However, while we're still simulating the transmitter and channel model, the receiver running in the OE is doing the actual demodulation. In this example, we would measure the real receiver's BER within SystemVue. To recap this SCA rapid prototyping demo, we started by creating, simulating, and testing a design in SystemVue. We then move that functionality into Spectra CX, where we created SCA components and waveform applications. We've installed and run an application on the Spectra OE, an SCA compliant operating environment. And finally, we've tied the simulation and running application together, providing new ways to simulate and test radio and waveform applications.